Contacts are classified into different categories: automatic, non-automatic, one-way, two-way, penalty-based and constraint-based contacts. The main purpose of contact is to detect the bodies during the simulation. The contact algorithm prevents the penetration of the nodes into element segments. Element segment is also nothing but the area of the element. In contact, with automatic option, the normal direction of the segment is not important. The contact will check from either sides if the automatic contacts are used. The shell elements are treated as solid elements in the sense shell thickness is always considered. Let's take this as a mid elements. After assigning the thickness, your element will behave like this. When you're using automatic contacts, always the shell thickness is considered. In non-automatic contacts, the normal direction of the segment is very important. That is, the normals of the master should point towards the slave. By using shell thickness in star control contact, when we are using non-automatic contacts, we can decide to include shell thickness to be considered or not. Now we will discuss about one-way and two-way contacts. In one-way contact, the slave nodes are tested whether they penetrate into master segment. One-way contact types allows for a compression loads to be transferred between the slave node and the master segment. One-way contact is preferable when master is a rigid body. For example, punch or die in a stamping simulation. Two-way contacts are nothing but the symmetric contacts. Here, the slave nodes are tested with the penetration with master segments and master nodes are tested for penetration into the slave segments. It's accurate but more time-consuming as contact friction or checking is from either sides. Automatic surface-to-surface is the best example for two-way contacts. If you are using soft parameter, it's a constraint-based. If you are not using any soft parameter, it's a penalty-based. The most important contact types are automatic surface-to-surface, automatic single surface, automatic general, and tight contacts. In tight, tight shell edge contacts are preferred as it will transfer nodal displacements and rotations. Automatic surface-to-surface contact is the best example of symmetric contact. In this, slave nodes will check in the penetration to the master segment and then master nodes will check the penetration to the slave segment. This card represents the automatic surface-to-surface, where SSID stands for slave set ID, MSID for master set ID. SS type stands for slave set type, this for master set type. Slave box ID, master box ID. SPR, slave set forces will be included if you are setting this option to 1. Master side forces will be included if you are setting MPR to 1. These two will get even only if we are activating star database NC force and star database binary int form. FS stands for static friction, FD for dynamic friction. DC is the exponential decay coefficient, VC stands for coefficient of viscous friction, VDC stands for viscous decay coefficient. Pen check or penetration check. It will search small penetrations in contact if you are setting value to 1. BT stands for birth time when contact surface becomes active, DT for death time when contact surface is deactivated. SFS stands for scale factor on default slave penalty stiffness, SFM for scale factor on default master penalty stiffness. These two are used in calculation of the spring stiffness, where K is equal to SLSFAC into SF into K into A by D for penalty based contacts. SST stands for optional thickness on slave surface, MST for optional thickness on master surface. These two are used when we are using tight contacts. SFST stands for scale factor for slave surface thickness, SFMT for scale factor for master surface thickness. FSF stands for Coulomb friction scale factor and VSF stands for viscous friction scale factor. Coming to the automatic single surface contact, it's a most common contact used in impact simulations. Single surface contact always considers shell thickness offsets. Only slave side has to be defined, master side is not required as master is assumed to be same as the slave. It is recommended to use single surface contact for crash and buckling analysis. Automatic general contact is preferable when there is possibility of two edges are coming in contact. We have to create beam with L form 1 and has to assign null material as it will not add any stiffness. Only slave side has to be activated, no need of any master surface. This contact will not work if there are any initial penetrations between the beams. Coming to the tight family. If two parts are glued in reality, then go with tight contacts. Tight contact is a permanent contact. There are different types of tight contacts, out of which tight challenge to surface beam offset is preferable as it will transfer both nodal displacements and rotations. Here we have to specify SST and MST. If you want to see the failure of the glue, then go with tie break contacts.